Welcome back to the Mile Pacers. Today we'll be reviewing the Brooks Hyperion Elite 2. With just kind of diving into a couple of specs here, it is a carbon fiber plated shoe, a marathon shoe to be exact. Also about this particular shoe from the Brooks. Couple specs jumping into it. This shoe was ran in a size 10 men in this video, with the stack heights in the heel of a 36mm and a 28mm forefoot, giving it a total of an 8mm drop. Very common with most carbon fiber plated shoes. And the weight coming in as a size in the size 9, it's a general size 9, is a 7.5, size 9's men, of course. Couple of specs here, starting with upper material. It is a featherweight stretch woven mesh. Very nice, silky and smooth upper material, in which just kind of having it to the touch towards the toe box area. Very breathable, and having those holes as well makes the top of the foot breathable as well. No issues with hot spots. Very wide platform in the toe box area, very wide platform, so you wouldn't have any of your toes overlapping to the side of the shoe or the upper material. It's also stretchy upper material as mentioned, but wide platform, so you would have no issues of comfort on the forefoot toe off area when you're running into the shoe. With the collar area being very thin, but towards the heel area having that type of cushion spot as well to kind of keep your heel cushioned with no type of Achilles rubbing or issues or blistering. Besides of the collar area, very thin, not too much padding at all or padding whatsoever. Doesn't bother at all, to be honest. And just kind of having this type of shoe, thin socks really works in my opinion, wearing this shoe true to size in a size 10, running in this shoe here. The laces, what I could say, just one thing about the laces is that the laces, it's a very stretchy lace, seems quite different and quite of an out of feel of the tie, but there's no issues whatsoever. It's not an augusted tongue, but it's a very thin tongue, not much padding at all really, but doesn't bother as well. It's just kind of more so the thing that just kind of bothers in terms of the upper material is just towards the collar area, the sides of it. If it just had a little more padding, then I would be fine. The sock really does accommodate in terms of the feel, but I would just more say that because of the less padding towards the sides of the collar area, the lockdown is not always the greatest, not the best, but overall very comfortable upper material running in this Brooks Hyperion Elite 2. Going down to the midsole technology of the Hyperion Elite 2, it is a DNA flash. The DNA flash contributes and has a nitrogen-infused chemistry or system into the midsole, which gives it a nice bounce to it, but still have a firmer landing in the Brooks Hyperion Elite 2. So it's a nice bounce, a bit of a softness to it, but firmer landing to kind of have that more of that, not more say ground feel, but is more, you could feel that it has its stack height, but it's more of a firmer landing. The carbon fiber plate is very rigid in this shoe, very rigid, even though it doesn't have a wide platform in the toe box, very rigid. You could definitely feel it, quite easy to take off in the toe off of the Hyperion Elite 2. With a rapid roll technology, in other words, kind of like the metal rocker system that this shoe has, you could definitely feel it, just kind of keeps you going. The outsole of the Hyperion Elite 2, I could see why they added the type of strips, two strips on the forefoot and also two strips of the heel, or just rubber, to kind of reduce the weight of the shoe, because you can see it has a very fat stack of midsole that kind of mostly contributes to the weight of the shoe. Very thin outsole, more exposed midsole, kind of providing that traction. Traction is not always there at times, because since that exposed midsole, it kind of could get slippery in terms of wet seasons. But the outsole still does the job its best it can to keep the traction. Not say it's the best, but it does its job. It's kind of reduced the weight. Durability, it really depends on how much mileage and value you put in the shoe, but I would say that it probably won't last as long as, let's say, the Endorphin Pro from Saucony. But overall, very nice shoe in terms of price budget. It is a bit pricey in the range, and what you got to consider in terms of durability and also how comfortable it feels in your foot. Not everybody's the same on how comfortable it feels in your foot, if it's worth it. But in my opinion, for a marathon shoe, it's nice and all, but not the top of my list. But it's still an overall shoe that I will still even have in my arsenal to choose from in terms of different type of races out there. More of a firmer landing, I would say. I would probably choose it in terms of a 5K, 10K. And it would fit really well in those type of races, in my opinion. But there's other options for more so half marathon and marathon distances, kind of giving more of the energy return that, in my opinion, the Brooks Hyperion Elite 2 may not offer me personally, and for in terms of my turnover of how I would use the marathon shoe. Other than that, that would conclude the review of the Hyperion Elite 2. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment and subscribe. Please also post notifications, ring the bell. It would really help us out and just getting this review out there to you. And if you have any questions, please, once again, we'll be more than happy to assist with what we know in terms of this review or any questions you may have regardless. We really thank you for your time and watching and tuning in, and we look forward to see you again at the Mile Pacers.